Welcome back guys. In this lecture, we are going to build Facebook client page with the help of Bootstrap grid system. So first let's look at the demo that we are going to build. Open Google Chrome and type FB Facebook. So here you can see this is the Facebook official home page or landing page. So we are going to build exact this landing page with the help of Bootstrap grid system. That means with the help of rows and columns. So if you observe the project here, we have the white smoke background color, and in this area we have the Facebook logo and some text about the Facebook, which is a paragraph text. This is the left side, and the right side we have one form. In that form we have two input fields with the values, email address or phone number, and the password. And bottom of that input fields we have the login button. After entering these input fields, the user has to click on this login button, then only these details will be verified. So there is one more option: if a user forgets his credential, that is called as forgot account. If you click on this, you will be able to see the forgot password page. So here we need not to discuss about this, we are building only login page. So after the forgot password button, we have one HR tag, that means underline. After the underline, we have the create new account, means registering a new user. So this is up to the form. Below the form, we have the create a page for a celebrity, band or business. This is for the promotional text. So this is what that we are going to build now with the help of Bootstrap grids, rows and columns. So if you observe the project clearly, here we have four columns for the right side, not right side, left side. For the text we have allocated four columns, and for the form we have allocated four columns. Not only four columns, but if you consider these total width is 12 columns, you can make these text part as 4 or 5 columns, and these form part as 4 or 5 columns. So remaining these 2-3 columns, here also remaining these 2-3 columns are empty. So that's why we need to utilize only 9 or 8 columns from the 12 columns, because this is the empty space. From the left side there is some empty space, and from the right side also there is some empty space. So you should not use all the 12 columns to build the content. If you use all the 12 columns, these Facebook text will start from here. So we should not do like that. So you should utilize only 4 or 5 columns for the text and 4 or 5 columns for the form area. So while building, you'll understand better. First, I will create a new folder on the desktop with the name Facebook. New Facebook. So this is the project folder. Now we have to access this folder in the VS Code. Open VS Code. Here we go. The VS Code is open. Now click on the file. Click on the open folder. Now select the Facebook folder on the desktop, where it is. Here you can see this is the Facebook folder. Click on this and click on the select folder button. You can see here the Facebook folder is opened on the VS Code. Now we have to create the index.html file and index.css file. First and foremost, we have to complete the basic setup in the index.html. HTML head, title is Facebook, control S. So now we have to write the body part. So before entering to the body part, we have to use the Bootstrap in our application. And if you want to use Bootstrap grid system, you should add one more tag, which is called as meta tag. So if you want to find that both the links, you can visit Bootstrap official website. This is the Bootstrap official website. Click on the get started. So copy the first link, which is used for CSS, that means Bootstrap CSS, paste it here. Click on the view. Toggle WordWrap. So if you want to use the Bootstrap grid system and make your website responsive, you have to add one more line, which is called as meta tag. So here you can find the meta tag. In the starter template, we need to copy this meta name is equal to viewport, content is equal to width, device width, you have to copy this line and paste it above the Bootstrap. So before using the bootstrap only, you have to paste the meta tag. Control S. So the bootstrap linking process is completed. Now we have to create the content in the body. So first we will see the actual project. So this is the actual project. So now I want to utilize 4 columns for the text purpose and 4 columns for the form purpose. So out of the 12 columns, I want to use only 8 columns, 4 for text and 4 for form. I want to place that 8 columns at the center of the page using the justify content center. So first we need to create a row. So first we need to create a row in the body, div class equal to row. And in that div, we have to divide the row into 2 parts. So the first part contains 4 columns, second part contains 4 columns. Class call MD 4. So if you only write call 4, that will work on only desktop device. If you write call MD 4, it will work on both desktop device and the mobile device. That's why we need to write call MD 4. MD means medium devices. Div class call MD 4. So these first 4 columns are for the text purpose and the next 4 columns are for the form tag purpose. So in the first 4 columns, first we have to create the H1 tag for the Facebook title. You can see here Facebook title. So we need to create the H1 in the Facebook. H1, we need to write the title. Facebook. So let's check the output. So in this tab, I will open our project, local disk C, desktop, Facebook folder, and file name is index.html. That's it. We got the Facebook H1 text at the page. If you want to bring these at the center of the page, not center, in the first 4 columns, because we are going to use only 8 columns from the 12 columns. So we need to bring everything to the center of the page to make our website like this. So here also they have used only 8 columns from the 12 columns, but they have used the justify content center to bring 8 columns to the center of the page. So that's why we need to bring 8 columns to the center of the page. So after the row, we need to mention the class as justify content center, control S. Here you can see the Facebook text is came to the center of the page. Now we need to add some margin top to our row, because the row is started from here. This is all called as empty space. That means margin. You can add margin or you can add padding, anything. Both will work for same, because there is no another element here. If you have any another element, we need to use only margin. If there is no another element, we can use both margin and padding. So I will use margin top 100 for the row. So the row will start from here. Here also the row will start from this space. So at the top we will have 100 pixels margin. So now I will enter into the index.css. So I will add margin to the dot row. That means row class. I will add margin top 100 px or I will add 150 px. Let's see how much it is taken. So first we need to link this index.css to index.html. So after linking the bootstrap, I will link the index.css. In the href, I will write index.css, control S. Let's check the output. Here you can see the Facebook text came down. Now we need to increase the size of this Facebook text. So if you observe the entire page here, we have only one H1 text. There is no another H1 text. So we need not to write any CSS selectors for this H1 text. Of course, if you want to write, you can write, but here there is no need of that. So simply I will write one H1 and I will increase the font size up to, initially the H1 text font size is 32px. So let's increase up to 50px. You can check whether the both the H1 texts are matching or not. Here you can see it's increased, but not exact. Sorry. desktop, Facebook. So the text size is increased, but not like this. So we need to increase some more. So instead of 50, I will write 70. Control S. Yeah, it's looking good. So afterwards we will change the color. Why afterwards? Now only we will change the color. Here you can see we have blue color for the H1 text. So I will use the color as blue for the H1 text. Color. So which blue should we use? I will use normal blue only. Control S. Let's check the output. Here you can see we got the blue text color for the Facebook logo. So below the Facebook logo, we have some text about the Facebook. So please copy this text and create a paragraph tag in our project. And we need to place this text in our paragraph tag. So bottom of the H1 text, we need to write one paragraph. Paste it. That's it. Let's execute this. Here you can see we got the paragraph text, but not as expected. If you zoom, you can able to see the paragraph text also in the two lines. Here you can see, suppose if you want to increase the paragraph text size, you can increase. That's up to you. So here I don't want to increase paragraph text. I want like these only. So the Facebook text part is completed. We have created the Facebook text part like this. If you want to change the font style also, you can change it, but it's not necessary here. We are focusing on Bootstrap grid system project only. So the text part is completed. That means we have completed the work part in the first four columns. Now we need to move to the second four columns. That means form part. So in the second four columns, first we need to create the form. So in that form, we need to add two input fields and one button. So I will add input type is equal to text, class is equal to form control, because we are using the Bootstrap forms, form control, and the placeholder is equal to email or phone number. Control S. Let's check the output. Here you can see a text is created in the second four columns. So now we need to create the second input field. You can copy this input field and paste it for the password also. So at the placeholder only we need to change the value. Instead of email or phone number, we need to write the password. Let's check it. Here you can see the second input field also created successfully. Afterwards, we will add the margin to these input fields. First, we will create all the input fields. So after the two input fields, we have the button. So this is the Bootstrap primary button. If you want to clarify, you can open Bootstrap official website to get this button. So this is the Bootstrap primary button. So after the two input fields, I will add the button. In the button, the text is login. And I will add the class as BTN, BTN primary. Control S. Here you can see the button is created successfully, but not exactly. So if you observe the project here, the button is full width. But when it comes to our project, the button is inline, because by default button is inline. It will take up to the content width only. To make this button full width, we need to add one more class, which is from the Bootstrap called as BTN block. So we can make the button to the block level. BTN block. Block level means it will take the full width of the parent. So for this button, the parent is form. So it will take the width of the form. Now I will hit the refresh button. Here you can see the button size is increased to the form level. Now we need to add the margin top and margin left right to all the elements. So margin left right is optional. We need to add the margin top only, because all the elements are stretched one after another. So now we need to move into the index.css. And first thing we need to add is input. For the input fields, I will write margin top 10px. Control S. And for the button also, we need to add the margin top. Button. Margin top 10px. Here you can see the button and the margins are created successfully. There is some gap between the one input field and another input field. So here you can see this is the input field. If you want to increase this, if you want to decrease the size of the input fields, you can give only 3 columns for the form tag. Then these size will be increased. So we have taken 4 columns for form tag and text tag. But if you observe the Facebook official website, they might have taken 4 columns for the text tag and 3 columns for the paragraph, not paragraph, form tag, because the text size width is bigger than form. So let's add the call M3 only. So call MD3 only. Now we can clarify that. Call MD3. Now it will look exactly like official website only. Yeah, now it's looking good. You can see exact same width for the both the official website and our developing website. So we have taken 4 columns for the text purpose and we have taken 3 columns for the form tag purpose. If you want to take 3, you can take 3. If you want to take 4, you can take 4. It is not there any condition that you should take both 4 and 4 only. You can take any number of columns out of the 12 columns. But when you add all the columns, it should not increase the 12. So a row has only 12 columns. That's why we need to divide the row into 12 columns only. So from the 12 columns, we have utilized only 4 columns. So I will use 4 columns because I will apply padding to the form tag. Here you can see there is some padding from the parent tag to the input fields. So I will use only 4, not 3, 4 only. So afterwards you will understand why I have taken 4. So now I will create the form tag. So in the index.css, I will apply the style to the form. So before applying style to the form, we have to apply the background color to the body. Here you can see this is not white color body. This is white smoke. The Facebook official website background color is white smoke. So in our website also, I will use the body and for that body, I will add the background color as white smoke. Body, background color, white smoke. Control S. Let's check this. Here you can see white smoke background color is created in our website also. Now I will add the background color for the form. If you observe the official website, there is white background color for the form. So in our website also, I will add the white background color for the form. So background color white. Control S. Here you can see the white background color is added to the form, but it is not visible because all the elements are stretched into the form. So we have to add some padding to the form. Then only we can able to observe the space from form tag to the input fields. So I will apply the padding 20, P20. That means after the 20 pixels gap from top, bottom, left, right only, the elements will start in the form tag. Now I will hit the refresh button. Here you can see, now you can able to observe the gap between the form tag and input fields. All these white color background color is form. And this is 20 pixels gap from left side, right side, in top and bottom. If you apply only padding, that will be applied to all the size. If you mention the size also, that will be applied to mention side. So if you apply padding left, that will be applied only left. If you apply padding right, that will be applied to only right side. So if you do not mention any side, that will be applied to the all the sides. That's why the space is from all the sides in the form. Now we need to add the border radius for the form. Here you can see there is some border radius to the form. In our website also, I will add the border radius for the form. So B radius, I will add 10px. Control S. Here you can see the border radius is applied successfully. Now we are left with some more input fields and form tag elements. After the login button, we have one anchor tag, which takes us to the another page, forgot account page. So we need to add one anchor tag after the logon button. So this is the login button. Here I will add the anchor tag with the text. What is the text? Forgotten account. So here I will write forgotten account question mark. Control S. Sorry, this anchor tag came down. Control S. Now let's check this. Here you can see we got the forgotten account, but it is at the left side. To make these at the center of the page, we need to add the class as text center, or we can add a text align center in the CSS. That's lengthy process. So we can add the class as text center to make any element to the center of the page. Text center, control S. Sorry, it's not working. So I forgot that this anchor tag element is the inline elements. We cannot make the inline elements to the center of the page. We can make only block elements. So here we need to add one more line to the class, which is called as btn block. Sorry, not btn block. We have to add the display block for the anchor tag, because by default anchor tags are display inline elements. So for the display inline elements, we cannot add any bootstrap classes like text center, justify content center, etc. So that's why we need to add the class as, not here, we need to add the text center only. But before adding this text center, we need to convert this anchor tag to the display block. So in the CSS, I will write anchor tag as display block. Sorry, display block, control S. Now let's check the output. Here you can see the text is converted to the center of the page. Here I refresh, you can see. So here I want to add some margin to the anchor tag. I want to add some margin top because it is exactly touched to the button. So I want to add some margin top. Margin top 5px or 10px. I will add 10px. Stretching towards. Refresh. Here you can see. Now there is some gap between the login button and the forgotten account anchor tag. So after the forgotten account anchor tag, we have one HR line. So here also I will add one HR line. HR. Let's check this. Here you can see we got one HR line. After the HR line, we have one more button, create a new account. So this is the bootstrap success button because it is having the green background color. So we need to add one button, which is called as button with the class. So before adding the class, we need to add the text, create new account. Create new account, class btn, btn success, control S. Let's check this. Here you can see this button is created successfully. If you want to bring this button at the center of the page, we need to add some styling to this button. So I will add the style as, first I will convert these btn success to the block level element because buttons are also inline elements by default. So I will write dot btn success, and here I will write display is equal to, sorry, display block, control S, and here we need to write the class is equal to text center, so it will came to the center of the page. Text center, control S. Let's check this. Here you can see there is no change in the output. Let's check the mistake. So in the index.css, I forgot to add the important keyword because here we are overriding the display property of the button, which is from bootstrap. So we are overriding the btn success class. It is the bootstrap class. So we need to add the important button. Control S. Now let's check. So again, it's not working. So there is something mistake in this text center class for buttons. Let's try to add the margin left and right to the buttons. So we can get that. So I will add margin left is equal to 50px. So after hitting the refresh button, this button will move 50 pixels right side. That means because we have added margin from here. So I will hit the refresh button. Here you can see it's moved right side. So if you want to bring to the center of the page, we need to increase the left margin. So instead of 50, I will add the 80. Control S. So I will add 100. Control S. Yeah, now it's looking good. So we have created the in create account button. Now we are left with only one thing, which is called as this paragraph text, create a page for a celebrity, brand or business. Here these create a page is called as bold text. We need to create the paragraph, and in that paragraph we have to create these create a page in the bold text. So after the form, so by this button the form is completed. So after the form we have to add one paragraph text P. We have to copy this text and we have to paste that in the paragraph. Copy paste Control S. Let's execute. Here you can see below the form tag we have the create a page for a celebrity, brand or business. So this is the official login page of the Facebook that we have created now. So you can see there is only little bit changes in our website because they have used different fonts in their website and we have used our fonts in our website. If you zoom, you can able to see very clearly. This is the Facebook logo and this is the Facebook text, and here we have the form. In that form we have two input fields, email, password and the login button, and here this is the anchor tag which is used for forgot password and the create new account. So in this entire project we have struck only at this button place only, because this class text center class is not working for button. That's why we have used the margin left. So after this button we have one only paragraph text below the form. So this is the Facebook landing page. If you want to add the footer also, you can add. So in the Facebook official page, here you can see there is some footer at the top, not top, bottom. If you want to add also, you can add. So here we are focusing only on landing page design. That's why we need not to add the footer. Thank you.